rising
Red
here.
Red sun rising.
Hello.
Because I'm just kind of, you know, just glossed over by my new friend Emo Rick.
Yeah, it's not emo yet, but now it is.
Now he's emo.
I thought this festival could be a lot better.
That's douchey. That's
douchey Rick.
Douchey Rick. I'm just going to call you Chad from now on.
There you go.
Because that's the name of every douche. It's Chad.
That's kind of true.
I'm back to normal Rick now.
Normal Rick, okay, so Red Sun Rising at Louder Than Life. It's louder, it's very loud, and it's colder than balls, and muddier than all get out. So how you guys, yes it is, how you guys enjoying our local weather? I mean, you guys are from Ohio, so you should be used to
this. This is nothing weird or new to us, the cold weather, so I'm glad everyone came out. And still, you know, sometimes like this kind of weather and the mud and the rain like actually make people more crazy, especially at a rock show, so we're excited about that. It was cool.
Are you guys gonna like mud up?
Hey! What's up? Good set.
I saw you sneak by.
Alright.
I say hi to Danny there.
I see that. Yeah. Well, I appreciate it. Thanks, Danny.
Yeah, he's putting us all on for us. So.
I know. Well, I mean, he's the man. He's the man. You gotta give homage to the man.
Absolutely. Say that we didn't expect it to go like as high as it is. Like right now it's number 3, and like it's surreal to us because, you know, we always believe in our music, but to see it actually happen is very surreal. So we're just really excited, and at every level of success it just makes us want to work harder, right, to stay here and go further. So
it's awesome motivation, you know, to keep going, you know, just keep going.
Yeah, to see it actually working is
very positive.
A lot of affirmation.
Yeah, absolutely.
That, you know, what you're doing is important, and it's
100%.
Yeah, it's great. I love it. So.
Originally, it was a song that we had written back in 2010, which didn't make the record. But the idea was polyester is something very cheap and obtainable, where zeal is something you strive for. So the juxtaposition between the two together is like, what's your obtainable dream? Like, what makes you happy, no matter what the cost is? And the cool thing is, this whole journey, and like us being able to record our first national record, go on the radio and play festivals like this, it became our polyester zeal. So it's like, this is our obtainable dream now. And so we thought it was very fitting for our first record.
Record to the next level.
The reason why we even went with Bob in the first place is one thing we we talked about when we were like basically interviewing him for the job. He said, "You guys have all the right stuff to make a beautiful painting. I just need to show you how to use it." And that's what he did. He didn't try to change us. He just took what we were already good at and then made that work.
How did he come with Emo Rick?
He hated Emo Rick.
He said, no one likes
Emo
Rick.
He's actually not allowed back to his house.
Yes, he's not. His parents disowned him. So he's going back to his house, which is under a bridge.
Oh, I thought it worked like at Cinnabon's.
He works at Starbucks.
Starbucks on the weekdays.
Exactly.
Actually, that's too mainstream. He works at a boutique coffee shop.
Yes. In Akron, Ohio.
And he does like, what is it, spoken word.
Word.
Yeah, he's spoken word
every weekend.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. At some dive bar in Akron, Ohio.
Yes. And it's usually like one or two words.
Yeah.
Yes.
Exactly.
Hey,
so,
yes.
So profound.
Exactly. Emo Rick.
Emo Rick.
More festivals, we do Rock Allegiance.
Yeah, that's next Saturday.
Which is cool. And then we go out with All That Remains, which is our label mates. And then we go out with Godsmack.
Yeah, we're very excited about that.
It'll be really Godsmack. Cool.
We're excited for it all. It starts on, I think the first day is October 14th.
Yeah.
That's really
in Grand Rapids.
We pretty much go straight into the holidays, so we're excited.
What are you going to do for the holidays, I mean?
I'm going to Disney World.
No, okay, I have a...
I'm just kidding.
From Seether.
Yes, and it had all these amazing old school movies and whatever.
Right? Old classics, yeah.
Yes, and you guys, you know, did some.
We actually just started watching that.
Yeah, which is weird because I think we lost it.
We lost it.
Yeah.
We
found it.
And you did some quotes from the movie. You did a lot of Ace Ventura, you know, Ask Me a Question.
Oh, yeah.
All this
That's
stuff.
All our band does is do Jim Carrey
quotes. Yeah.
Always.
Except for Emo Rick because he's
very Jim Carrey.
He doesn't believe in Hollywood. He calls it Follywood.
He calls it Bougie. So, you know, you said you just started watching that series. Are there any other movies that you've been watching?
That's a good one. The Grumpy Old Men, that's a classic one.
Yeah.
He likes our classic 90s comedies.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, John Hughes.
And,
Frickin' Pink.
Some Uncle Buck.
It's a classic.
Uncle Buck.
Dumb and Dumber.
Yeah. Of course, Dumb and Dumber. It's a classic. Yeah, that's about it. Other than that, but it's been on the road.
Fun times. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you so much, too.
Thank you so much.
It's funny that...